One question I get from my students quite a bit is, how do I make a scale quantizer in Max? It's actually pretty easy, so I'm going to show you how to do it. First of all, we're going to start with our incoming note into our system. So I'm going to create a number box just by hitting the I key for integer. And let's specify the properties here. So I hit Command I to open up the inspector, and I'm going to change the display format to MIDI notes. And I find it's also helpful to set the minimum maximum values to 0 to 127. So this represents any MIDI integer coming into our system. And you can see there's like some sharps here. And we're going to quantize that to whatever scale we want. It doesn't have to be a diatonic scale. It could be a pentatonic scale. It could be just like, you know, root and fifth, whatever you want. This is up to you. You're making your own scale quantizer. We're going to create like a C Ionian diatonic scale. The first thing that we need to do is separate this information from this number box into two bits of information. One is going to represent the pitch class, which is an integer that is going from 0 to 11. And then the other bit of information is which octave that is actually relying on. So what we need to do is we need to take this number box and we need to strip the octave information out of it. Now remember, this is just a number box that's showing us of an integer between 0 and 127. So we want to first of all just obtain the pitch class. So a C is going to be represented by an integer of 0, and then a C sharp would be represented by an integer of 1, and so on, all the way up to B, which would be represented by an integer of 11. So mathematically, this is what's known as the modulo operator. And we want to separate this into classes of 12 subdivisions. So the modulo operator is the little percent sign, and I enter in an argument of 12. And if I just like grab this number box that we've already formatted into MIDI messages, MIDI integers, you can see that we get that first octave no matter where I'm at with this incoming MIDI note. And if I were to display this with an integer, we're going to see a number between 0 and 11. So as I move this up, you can see it goes up to 11 and then recycles back starting at 0 on our C. So that's the pitch class. Now we need to extract the octave information. The octave information can be derived just simply by dividing the input by 12. And you will see that the first octave in our MIDI system here is going to give us a 0. And as we move up to the next octave, here we are at C1. Now you can see we're at octave 1, and this will go all the way up to octave 10 because we have about 10 octaves specified in the MIDI spec. So now we have these two numbers. This is the pitch class and this is the octave. Now the reason we're separating out this octave information is because we're going to use a call to look up the output of this pitch class and then constrain it to the values that we want. So let's go ahead and create a call. So I hit N for new object and I'm going to type in call. And the very first thing when you create a call is you really almost always want to embed the information in the patcher. And the easiest way to do that is just to use the at embed argument with a value of 1 to indicate that it's on. It's just a little flag, 1 is on, 0 is off. And we're going to edit this information directly in the call. So I'm going to double click on the call and I get my call editor here. And we want to process these numbers 0 through 11. So I'm just going to enter those in 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And then we need to follow this with a comma that delineates the index from the values that the call is actually accessing. So I find it's really easy just to enter in the comma and use the down arrow key to go to the next line. So now we have to make some decisions about the values that these are going to represent. So C is 0, so that should definitely remain a C. And then when I'm done, I close that with a semicolon. Then C sharp, this is where some of your judgment has to come into play. Like, does a C sharp translate to a D in C Ionian, or does it translate to a C? I'm going to weight this more heavily to the root, so I'm going to say that's going to be also a 0. So 2 is going to be a D, that should always be a 2, and that's the D sharp, and that will also be a D. 4 is a third, so we're going to have that output our 4. And then 5 is also going to be a 5, that's our fourth, that's our F. Now 6, we probably want to send that up one level, so that's going to go to the fifth, so 6 is going to go to 7. 7, of course, will be 7, that's our G, and then we can also emphasize the G more. So if a G sharp comes in, we can translate that down to a G. A should stay an A. Our A sharp should go to an A or the seventh. Let's have it go to the seventh. So I'll have it go up to 11. And this will go to 11. So I've defined one octave of our pitch class. You're not just allowing which pitches are going through, but you're also specifying which values are weighted to what they're translated into. So when we're done with this, just hit the validate button. And now this call should output a C diatonic scale regardless of what number is coming into it. So we shouldn't see any sharps or flats as I move through this. So you can see like this is an A sharp and it's outputting a B. Now I need to marry this back with the octave information. And this is going to seem kind of weird, but in order to convert this number, which represents octaves, into a semitone offset, I'm going to multiply it by 12. So I've divided by 12 to get the octave, and I multiply it by 12 to get the semitone offset. When I move this number, you should see this increment in banks of 12, and that's correct. So we're going to take this pitch class and add it to our octave, and this is going to produce the final quantized output. So I just use an add object here and plug this into the left and right operand. And then finally, that will get us to this ending point. So we should just see, regardless of what octave we're playing, you should see a C Ionian output. And we do. So there you go. That's how you make a pitch quantizer.